In all due respect to your great athletic ability, Jimmy, they've really got their work cut out for them with these Samoans.
I think there's a few differences between the Midnight Express and the Samoans, understand?
You know, Jim, the difference between the Samoans and the Midnight Express, when they're on the beach, they're climbing palm trees, shaking coconuts out of them. When we're on the beach, we're sipping pina coladas out of those same coconuts. When they're on the beach, they're rubbing sticks together to form a fire to boil some guy's head. And we're rubbing suntan oil on some bronze bathing beauty like these pretty girls right out here, right, Jim?
You know something, Paulie? Dangerously, you want to be like me so bad, you go out and you get yourself an interview segment. You get yourself a bodyguard like I used to have. Jack Victory could not guard the sugar bowl at a tea party. Then you go out and you think to keep the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette away from that scrawny little pencil neck of yours. You go out and you get the Samoans. They're big, rough tough, they're man-eaters, they're cannibals. Well, let me tell you something right now, Polly. No two bearded, frizzy-headed geeks from Gilligan's Island are going to coast over here on a raft through the Pacific Ocean and get in the ring with the Midnight Express, beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan in the National Wrestling Alliance and do anything but go down to defeat. We beat all the best teams, and I don't care if we keep the Samoans maybe from trying to chew on our fingers or bite on our legs. I hope Polly feeds them. If not, I'll bring some fish heads to ringside so they won't be hungry. And if they've had their shot, and Polly, the Samoans are going down to defeat, and beautiful Bobby Sweet Stan and Jim Cornette are going to be knocking on your front door, and we're going to have the back door bolted so you can't run and hide.
All right, gentlemen, thank you very much, fans. The hottest number in wrestling is the Wrestling Hotline. Here's a special announcement about that important.
It's new. It's the Wrestling Hotline. Now, keep up with the latest breaking action in the NWA by calling 1-900-909-9900. Hear all your favorite wrestlers, plus Jim Cornette's insult of the week.
It's here, Wrestling Hotline. Just dial 1-900-909-9900. Even a moron like Paulie Dangerously can remember 1-900-909-9900.
So if you've only got one call to make, make it the Wrestling Hotline. 1-900-909-9900. Kids, get your parents' permission before calling.
He's quite impressive in the ring, regardless of what we think about him. He is a little outspoken.
George Stout, the opponent here, and the Iron Sheik, as we mentioned, representing the Iranian army. He got in the army as a teenager in his native land, was the youngest member of the Iranian Olympic team, and to this date, he is still the youngest man ever to win an Olympic medal from Iran. And there's just not too many guys in pro wrestling that have competed successfully in the Olympics. This man has done that.
Well, his credentials and background speak for themselves, and he definitely speaks for himself inside the square circle. He's the most devastating man I've seen come to this country in quite some time.
He's a master of Greco-Roman wrestling, master of freestyle wrestling. He's been a world champion not only in the pros, but also in the amateurs. He's a very sadistic man, too, and I think that may be characteristics of his background, perhaps.
Very punishing athlete, but he's such a master of all the suplexes, and, I mean, just a tremendous technical wrestler as well as being so vicious.
Gut-wrench suplex, and I think we could hear him say he wants to punish him. And he is, as I said, a very sadistic individual as he sends George South for the ride. High elevation, George South, now up in the lights. This man is certainly a force to be reckoned with, whether it be American athletes or anybody else. I don't know who. Well, he's for his country, and that's it.
That was certainly a very lucrative challenge he threw out there. $20,000 is a lot of money. We're seeing a lot of money thrown around out here today, period.
We certainly have. We've had the $10,000 challenge. Those are very unusual wrestling boots that he's wearing, and the source of a lot of controversy throughout his career.
Well, he has been known to utilize the kick a little more devastatingly than would seem possible with a pair of regular boots. It has been questioned that there might be a little lead possibly in one of those.
The abdominal stretch, and it is perfectly applied to George South by the Iron Sheik, the Olympic medal winner from Iran.
Not a real fan favorite.
Oh, he's certainly not. Very belligerent regarding what our country stands for as opposed to his background.
Well, claiming superiority and proving here in the NWA will be quite a different matter, because we know this is the hotbed of professional wrestling.
The Iron Sheik with the blatant chokehold on George South. Don't forget, fans, the NWA tonight in Greensboro at the Coliseum. Tomorrow night right here in Atlanta in the Omni, right here in the wrestling capital of the world. That's a 7:30 starting time tomorrow night in the Omni. Be fans in and around the Atlanta area. Great seats are still available at all seats outlets, including the Omni box office. That was a thunderous chop, a double chop there by the Sheik, and I hate this part. Spatting on these American kids that are just here to compete. George South is probably one of the finest young men out of the ring that I've ever met in the NWA. He's here to compete, and this man is certainly insulting, I think, a lot of Americans by his actions, not only verbally at Magnum, but his actions, of course, in the ring as well.
Well, he certainly brings new meaning to the word nasty. I don't think anybody's going to have any compassion for this guy when he gets his due.
Iron Sheik, there looks like another suplex coming. Belly-to-belly suplex. And he did not, he may have been able to pin him right there, but he decides to punish him some more, and that's exactly the mode this man is wrestling in that punishing mode. Oh, that's vicious, belly-to-back suplex.
Executed with a lot of authority, not a real quick wrestler, but everything he does, he's nailing right on the money.
Man, I don't know anywhere in the world he's going to go except maybe his native country where he's going to get hear a pleasant word as he sets George South, it would appear, for the camel clutch. And this is one of the most feared maneuvers in the sport. You've got to have your opponent in a real helpless position to get him there. But he's very proficient in that. And there's a submission hold right here. George South has given it up. George South has given it up. And look at the expression on this man. He is a sadistic individual, so anti-American, it is pathetic. Well, let's take another look. He's really a discouraging individual. In the land of the free, where he has the First Amendment rights, and he really has used them to its full extent.
Well, Jimmy, pretty much had it all over by this point. The man was, as you said, helpless. He sets him up, he squats down, he's got the man's arm straight back up over his knees, and he settles down with all that weight right across the lower back, and it's all over.
Ladies and gentlemen, when we come back, the Danger Zone. Paulie Danger's special guest will be Lex Luger.
I just figured we'd bring the guy out here, let him flex and go.
Are we on? Oh, hi. Sorry about that. Welcome to the Danger Zone. Of course, this is Paulie Dangerously. You know, ever since I took this segment from Jim Cornette, ever since I fired Magnum TA from his own segment, I've been thinking, let's just have the great athletes of the NWA out here. Let's not have any of these guys that lose all the time. So last week, I had Ric Flair. The world heavyweight champion in my book. So this week, I got the United States Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. Please, boo and throw inanimate objects at Lex Luger, huh? If he ever shows up. Oh, here he is, my guest. Thank you for coming out. The heavyweight champion of the United States. Lex Luger. The United States champion. What an honor it is to have an athlete of your caliber up there, because I tell you what, Lex, not only did I watch your match against Barry Windham, I myself, and so was Secret Service Jack Victory, I was very, very impressed with your victory over Barry Windham, because I personally know that your shoulders were indeed up. Of course, I think Barry Windham's shoulders were up too. But I mean, who the heck am I? I'm not a referee, you know. But you know, you are the United States Heavyweight Champion. Congratulations.
You know, despite your generally obnoxious demeanor, I guess in general, I should congratulate you. You've really moved up in the world. Your own segment on TBS. National TV, congratulations.
Thank you. You know, I bought this myself. I bought it. Ted Turner had nothing to do with it. I came in here. I said, TBS, I want my own segment. And I bought it to have athletes such as yourself out here. And I know, being that you're the United States Heavyweight Champion, that you're going to want to defend that belt against all comers. But, you know, Barry Windham's looking for your hardest of them all, man.
Well, I stated this, Barry Windham gave me a shot at it. I'll be glad to give Barry Windham a shot at it anytime he wants.
You know, not only are you defending your title against everybody, you're defending it against Barry. Maybe one day you'd like to meet Secret Service Jack Victory, but I tell you what, I hear...